course, Director.
Thank you.
each month so that they have food and clothing. That is an area that I desperately want to shine. And I know that one day I will bring home one of those babies and make a forever family for them. So that's why I want to shine, but why do you want to? So if we want our warmers to shine, we have to turn them on, right? I mean, they look really great when they're just sitting on a table or whatever, and when you look at them in the catalog, they're pretty. But when you flip that switch and the light comes on and the wax starts to melt and the fragrance is released, that is when the magic happens. So we want to be that way ourselves. We want to flip our switch and turn our light on so that we can shine and we can make a difference and we can make the magic happen for the people around us. And I used to be scared to death to shine. I was absolutely petrified because anybody who knows me knows that I am attention deficit to the max. I'll probably forget what I'm saying while I'm up here. I forget everything, I'm a mess, I'm constantly starting projects and not completing them. So this one day, I'm getting ahead of myself. So that was what scared me from shining, because I was afraid that people would be like, why is she trying to be all encouraging and like great when she thinks she is? Like, she's not an authority, she's a mess. And I saw her the other day drive around the parking lot 3 times because she had no idea which store she was supposed to go to. She's not doing what she's doing, I'm not going to listen to her. So I was afraid that people were going to see my mess and not hear my message. So a lot of times I just didn't say anything. Through a lot of circumstance and prayer, I was led to find out that that's actually the thing that draws people to me a lot of times. People can relate to the fact that I most certainly do not have it all together. And so I want to share with you a Facebook post. Is anybody friends with me on Facebook? So you'll probably remember this Facebook post. Let me pull it up really fast. I've got a screenshot. I don't have to like go through all the 8 million posts. Okay, so I put up this post on Facebook. I said, this was on a day that I was just feeling like a mess. I had started every single task that you can imagine in my house, and I had not completed any of them. And so I was just feeling discouraged and upset, and I sat down and I started writing out the things that I actually had done that day so that I could, you know, make a pat myself on the back so I feel better. So it led me to write this Facebook status, and I said, I'm not fit. I don't have the perfect body. You needed me to tell you that because you couldn't tell. My hair is almost always in a knot on top of my head. My yoga pants have never been to yoga. My house is a mess. My car has empty cups in the cup holders and crumbs on the floor. My to-do list is long and my ta-da list is pretty short. And the rest of the status says this: but today I've spent time in prayer. I've told my husband that I love him. I'm missing my family, so I'm just being like so emotional. I'm such a girl. I played in the water with Libby while she took her morning bath. I delivered forgotten PE shoes to Lily at school. I've encouraged a friend, and I've unloaded half of the dishwasher only to forget what I was doing. I'm a mess, but I'm God's mess. And I just thought somebody else might need to realize that about themselves today. Can anybody out there relate? Have you had days?
Yeah.
So a lot of people related to that. And I got a ton of comments and likes on the post. And then people started messaging me and texting me and calling me, telling me that made a difference to them and that they really could relate. And a couple people actually used the hashtag I'm God's mess in that post, and a couple other people actually did that. I was like, oh my gosh, I'm a rock star, I started a hashtag. And so why does that matter to the business? Why does that story matter? It matters because getting involved in other people's lives and making a connection with them matters, and that matters big time. Because when you start connecting with people, that's when you start having a bond with them. That's when customers are loyal to you. That's when hostesses want more of what you've got. That's when potential team members want to be a part of your little community. They want to be a part of what you're doing. That makes a huge difference. And I want so badly for you guys to know and learn today and just write this on your heart and remember these words, that you can shine too. You and your little mess can bring a message to the world. And you can bring, you can bring light to the world. You don't have to be afraid like I was for so long. You don't have to let anybody tell you that you can't. You can make a difference. How can you shine? Look for someone who needs encouragement. Do you know how to tell if someone needs encouragement? Look at them and check to see if they're breathing. Because if they're breathing, they would like to be encouraged. Raise your hand if you don't like to be encouraged. See? You can help someone. And you might be able to help someone just by, maybe there's someone that you know who's struggling financially. You could help them and show them your possibility packet. You could find someone who's new to the area. Maybe they just moved into your neighborhood. You could go introduce yourself and take them to one of your home parties so they can meet some new friends and get to know some people. You could help someone just by, maybe you know someone who's not a great gift giver, and you can help them become a great gift giver with products out of your catalog. There's lots of different ways that you can help people, so just find someone that you can help and do that. Shine for them. Now let's talk about why people are drawn to light. You might be familiar with a little warmer, I don't know, it's kind of popular, you might remember it, it was called Chasing Fireflies. So it's only the most popular Scentsy warmer that we've ever had. How many chased fireflies when you were little? Okay, why would you chase them instead of like flies or like something? Because they were cool and they shine. Yeah. When you were chasing after them, I want you to picture back. It's like a hot summer night. And you're running through your backyard and you're a little kid. And just like picture it. Were you looking for the biggest, most spectacular, most awesome firefly to catch in your jar? No. Were you looking for the tiniest, cutest, most perfect little, perfect firefly? Which one are you looking for?
The one that shines the brightest.
The one that shines that you can see, right? That's the one that you chase after. Like, and if you're like me, you had ADHD, you were like, that's how I was. I never caught it because I was chasing it. Okay, so take that and internalize it. Remember that you don't have to be the biggest, most grandest, most awesome superstar director with a million people on your team for people to pursue you. You don't have to be the tiniest, cutest, most perfect, perfectly dressed, perfect hair, perfect everything for people to pursue you. You don't have to be that. All you have to do is shine. All you have to do is be available. You all have to do is let people see you and show up and be there and be a bright spot in their day, and they will pursue you. And we want customers to pursue us, right? We want hostesses and potential new team members, we want them to pursue us. So what I want you to do is to find a cause that just wrecks your heart, like I feel about orphanages. I want you to find a person that needs encouragement. I want you to find a goal that makes your heart just pound and you start smiling, and when you think about reaching that goal, it just seems like the most awesome thing that can happen. I want you to shine toward those things. Don't just shine so that you can be spectacular. Shine towards something. And I really need somebody to dim the lights. Can we do that? So if you guys have your cell phones, if they're not dead yet, I want you to turn on your light like that. Hold it. We can't do this stuff? Oh, there we go. Okay, don't shine it yet. Hold it down. I have it ready. I want to show you how one or two or three people just shining brightly can make a huge difference. So I'm going to call out all of the ranks in the Cincy Family Compensation Plan. And when I call out your rank, I want you to shine your light. Superstar directors, I really need you to be on this. Oh, borrow my face. Steve, give her your hat. Okay, so when I call out your rank, I want you to raise up your light and shine. Superstar directors. There's only a few of them, but we're going to see what a difference they made. Star directors. Directors. Superstar consultants. Star consultants. Lead consultants. Certified consultants. Essential consultants. Look around. Those blue superstar directors shined and shined and shined and kept shining until they made all of those other people shine their lights too.